My name is Virginia. I have a tattoo. It's an octopus. This is it. It's the most important thing about me. Take it in. Let's cover it. The most important thing about my octopus is that it doesn't mean anything. Like, it has no deeper meaning. If it means anything at all, it means that at one point I had $500. And I can still look at it and remember, like, that time. It feels good. I met a lady who had a tattoo with, like, words on it. It was, like, language. And it was English, which I speak and read. And so that has to mean something. And I read it, and I said, honey, do you have a Mr. tattoo? And she said, no, it's the Beatles. And she was very mad. And it was the song Blackbird. It was the song that goes, na, 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 na. And the part she had was, take these broken wings and learn to fly. Okay. But it's also, take these broken wings and learn to fly. It's the same words. They're gonna know it's the Beatles. What if the person you're talking to isn't cool? If you wonder at all who I am the girl who will watch an old man sleep on a bench in an art museum for way too long. Because I am not sure he is not art. And I won't be fooled again. It simply will not happen. This is the year I decided, like, I've worked hard, I deserve things, I deserve nice things, and I decided this is the year I'm gonna do it, right? I'm gonna have a mink coat. But then I only had one mink, so what I did was I cloned him 50 times. And then I had this beautiful coat, all the same animal. And when people ask me, how many of God's innocent creatures did you that you had to die for you to have that coat, I can tell them just one. You know, just one. Just one. But he died a lot. Gentlemen, it's a hard time for you guys. I'm an ally. You're very brave for coming to an all-women show. I'm pro you guys. Hashtag not all men. I get it. I hear you. I'm with you, I'm here for it. And I get it. I get it when you say you don't like feminism. I get it. Because it always sucks when your slaves are freed. Because who's gonna do the dishes now? Do I have to do it? It does bother me when women say they aren't feminists, though, because then they say something that doesn't have anything to do with anything. They say, I'm not a feminist because I like to wear makeup and date men and I want to have kids. I'm like, did you know? Did you know that feminism is not about the shit that you want to do? If you take it down to its core principles, like what is it for, what does it function for, what feminism means is that a single woman doesn't have to become a prostitute when her dad dies, right? Like, that's what it is. I'm a divorced person, which is okay. I learned a lot being married. I don't care for it, me personally, as a person. And I learned that marriage is like the puzzle game of Jenga. Like, it can stand for a long time, even though it's full of holes and has really no foundation to speak of. And I learned that both things can be destroyed by one fat whore at a party. My husband was one of the Burning Man people. You know what they are? It was very trying because he would walk around all day with a headache because he wouldn't take an Advil because Western medicine is poison. You know? But he would take any pill given to him by a man wearing a fur vest. Which has never been what a doctor looks like in Western culture. There's one thing that male comics do that bothers me on stage. I don't like it when male comics wear wedding rings on stage. You know? Because, like, why would I listen now? You know, it's like, honey, if you're so funny, why don't you go home and make your wife laugh, you little slut? I'm not having kids, and I know it seems like, oh, but you have it so together. I'm not having kids. There's advantages. Did you know that if you don't have kids, you don't have to recycle? It is not my job to leave a better world for anyone. My sisters are having kids. They're doing the work, you know? And so I have two nephews, and I love them both. I love one of them a little more, because one of them makes me feel cooler than the other one. One of the boys is biracial, and that makes me feel cool. And the other one, like, I love him, but, like, he's just white people. Like, did we need him? Did we need another white man? Did we need him? Is he a nice to have or a have to have, you know?